Hello, is this Brian Zane?
Yes. Who is this?
You'll find out soon enough. Why don't you come to my office? We need to talk.
Bring him in.
Hey, what are you doing, man? Get your hands off me! Hey, come on! What are you doing, man? Hey, I'm a citizen. I have rights. Come on. Ah.
Oh, it's you. Glad you're here, Zane. It's time we finally had a chance to talk.
Why'd you bring me here? What's going on?
You've been a busy boy these last couple of years, haven't you? Making fun of WWE? Making fun of wrestling? I can't believe you had the nerve to say that Lita had a bad entrance theme!
Yeah, you and the rest of the internet, apparently.
What was that?
Nothing.
We've blocked some of your more offensive videos in the past, but it's clear we're not getting through to you yet.
Oh my god! Are you gonna beat me up?
No. My plan, Zane, is to break your spirit, break your will. I'm gonna make you review something that's so bad, so offensive, so catastrophic that your mind will collapse in on itself. You will have no choice but to give up this foolish endeavor of yours.
You can't scare me, Triple H. I've seen some shit. What could you possibly do that could break me? Are you serious? This is something you guys did.
I'm sure you'll have no problem tearing this apart like you do everything else. But be careful. You might not like what you find when you dig deeper. Now get out of here. Go back to your home. I look forward to seeing this review.
Well, here we are. I'm Brian Zane, and I'm here to review The Exploitation of the Death of Eddie Guerrero. I'm kind of surprised Triple H asked me to talk about this. After all, it's one of the most tasteless things WWE has ever done, which says a lot, considering how Eddie's name was used and abused, and looking at the careers that were negatively impacted by the ensuing idiocy, wouldn't this be something they want to keep under wraps? November 13th, 2005. Now, had they ended it there, it would have been okay. It would have been tasteful. It would have been appropriate. Anything beyond that, well, it would have been a letdown. But ask yourself, dear viewers, has WWE ever let you down? In letting you down.
I killed The Undertaker!
We'll get back to Orton in a minute, but first, let's talk about a plucky little fellow named Rey Mysterio. Ah yes, Mysterio. Undoubtedly one of the most popular wrestlers ever to grace WWE, Mysterio is a champion of the underdog. Despite being much smaller than the average WWE star, Rey's ability, his charisma, and his flashy look made him irresistible to fans. Now that I think about it, Rey Mysterio in a way kind of reminds me of Eddie Guerrero in that undersized guy but with his big charisma gets over on his own with the fans. So I guess what was about to happen makes a lot of sense in that regard. What if WWE wanted to spiritually give Eddie Guerrero a push, but since he was obviously no longer with us, what if they wanted to give that push to Rey Mysterio instead? Oh god, this is not going to end well. Rey said he was dedicating his performance of the match to his late friend. Certainly a nice gesture, even though it gave away the finish. Imagine how awful it would have looked for Rey Mysterio to lose just after dedicating the match to his fallen friend. It certainly would have made the babyface look like an idiot, right? Oh, yeah.
Oh, God, you gotta be kidding me. Eddie.
Ah. I'm only doing the bare minimum of acting, so I can get paid tonight. So after that stupid whatever, Rey went on to win the Royal Rumble after drawing number 2. Fun fact, this is the same Rumble match that put the wheels in motion for the Shawn Michaels-Vince McMahon feud, which ended with that spectacular match pitting the McMahons against Michaels and God at Backlash. Boy, 2006 was kind of a shit year for the company, huh?
Hello, Zane. How's the review coming along?
Terrible, H. Just terrible. And I'm just getting started. We haven't even gotten to the most offensive stuff here yet, but if you think this is gonna break me, break my spirit, man, you better think again.
We'll see, Zane. We'll see. I'll be checking up on you again soon.
By this point, WWE had used Eddie's name so much in the build to Ray's win in the Rumble, it would have been silly not to carry that over toward the build to WrestleMania. Silly, yes, but also forgivable. And if there's one thing the company will never do, it's look silly.
Eddie ain't in heaven. Eddie's down there, in hell!
I don't even have a joke for this. I mean, that is just reprehensible. It's unforgivable. I mean, okay, you could in some small way, with some leap of logic, argue that these people on TV are just characters. They're just fictional representations of themselves on this fictional television show. So these characters are the ones saying these awful things, so that's more forgivable. But no, we see that the problem with that logic is that Eddie Guerrero really died. Not just the character Eddie Guerrero, the man himself. How on earth can they justify this? The Eddie Guerrero Memorial Tour reached its zenith at WrestleMania 22, when Mysterio beat Kurt Angle and Randy Orton to become the World Heavyweight Champion, and went on to have one of the worst reigns of all time. In the 4 months that Mysterio held the title, Rey's singles record was 7-7-2, losing to guys like Mark Henry, the Great Khali, and Finlay, losing clean no less. The few people he did beat, it was rarely ever convincing. You'd be hard-pressed to find a world champion with a worse track record. Not only was Mysterio being presented like a chump despite being champion, he was doing so while carrying the banner for his dead friend. This is how you're gonna honor his memory? Mysterio mercifully lost the belt to King Booker in July after interference from Chavo Guerrero. Some fans were upset that Chavo, the actual Guerrero still working for WWE, was pushed aside in favor of Mysterio in the wake of Eddie's death, that by being related to Eddie, Chavo was more deserving of a push. Well, aside from the fact that one charity push isn't better than another, it all came down to simple business. Mysterio is, was, and forever will be over with the fans, thanks in large part to his wrestling style and his look. Meanwhile, Chavo as a solo artist has always been about as fun to watch as your dad's colonoscopy video. Of course Mysterio would get the nod over Chavo, it was the only sensible decision made during this entire debacle. Besides, Chavo and his fans had already been given the greatest gift of all, the end of this. Oh, I should mention that along with casting Eddie's nephew as a heel, they also went ahead and did the same thing to Eddie's widow, Vicky. Because when it comes to offending people, the WWE knows no bounds. In October of 2006, Chavo defeated Mysterio in an I Quit match and moved on to a feud with Chris Benoit right after. Although Eddie's name was bandied about during that feud as well, what we've already seen was about as bad as this awful chapter in WWE history was going to get. You know, every time the fans would get upset over how Eddie's name was being exploited, or every time a writer would stand up and say how tasteless this all was, the company always stood by the constant fact, according to them, that Eddie would have wanted this. Eddie would have wanted it to be like this. Well, let's review for a minute. WWE totaled his symbolic car. They turned him into a mischief-making specter. They had one of the top heels of the company say he was in hell, and they forced perfectly capable workers to carry the banner for the guy, all while looking like losers. Is this really what Eddie would have wanted? Just think about this for a second. If this is how they treated somebody they loved, imagine how they would have treated someone they hated. There was some good that came out of all this madness. Like I said earlier, it brought an end to Chavo's idiotic Kerwin White gimmick, and Vicky Guerrero went on to become one of the best heels the company ever had. Mysterio's run as an honorary Guerrero turned him into a bona fide main eventer, even though he was much better at chasing the belt than he was at holding it. But those perks were not worth all the fans had to go through. Damn it. This is such a hard one to review, you know? I wish it had never happened so I didn't have to review it. I wish Eddie were still with us, and I wish WWE weren't so low as to try and cash in on Eddie's death. Shame on you, WWE. Shame on you.
Are we really the villains here, Zane? Is it really all of our fault?
What do you mean? Of course it is. Who else could it have been?
I've got an idea. Why don't you look in your dresser drawer and find out? Now take a look at your bookshelf. And what about your DVD collection?
Well, that's not fair. I bought this one before he died.
The point is, you and all the fans spoke with your wallets, and we answered. When you spent all that money supporting Eddie Guerrero after he died, we realized we could keep him alive forever through our storylines. We did it with the NWO. We did it with ECW. We did it with WCW. We make a t-shirt of something the fans miss. They buy it. We milk the nostalgia dry, and the cycle continues.
My God. It all makes sense now. You guys saw that people would buy anything with Eddie's face on it, so you felt justified in turning Eddie into a storyline. You played us like suckers. I don't even know what to think anymore.
You can't come to terms with hating something that you yourself caused. That paradox is making you question everything you stand for, and soon you will give up. It's what's best for business.
You're right, Triple H. God, you're right.
Don't listen to him, Zane.
Who's that?
Brian, you're not gonna believe what that jerk says, are you?
The ghost of Art Barr? Is that you?
No, you big dummy! It's me, Mike the Maleficent Love Machine, Tough Enough Sensation!
Actually, you didn't make the cut.
That's not important right now. That jamoke Triple H knows what he's saying is garbage. It's not the fans' fault that WWE ran Eddie's name through the dirt. That company's just lousy at reading their audience. Those guys need a good dick kicking, and I'm just the guy to do it.
Ah, jeez, not that guy again. You're not getting past security this time, Mike.
That weirdo in the mask is absolutely right. Yeah, sure, Triple H. We bought the Eddie Guerrero t-shirt and the DVDs and the books and all that stuff. That's because we loved him. We were sad that he was gone, but we didn't want him to become a friendly ghost or be inserted into storylines as if the payoff was going to be Eddie rising from the grave and giving Randy Orton a frog splash. Because the proceeds went to his family, buying that stuff was our way of saying thank you to the man who gave us his gift in the ring. We got to remember him through his work, we grieved with the loss, and we moved on. That's how the process works! It's one thing to milk a dead brand like ECW or the NWO, but you can't do that to a real-life person. Even though it's within your right as a business to do so, you should not exploit the legacy in the name of Eddie Guerrero like you did. To invoke the name of someone who died on your watch, to put his friends and family through all this fake fighting over his legacy just to make a buck and to advance storylines, that's not what we signed up for. We deserved better. Eddie deserved better.
You're not gonna break me, Triple H. As long as my show exists, I will continue to belittle and make fun of your company's poor decisions, of pro wrestling's poor decisions, and put these reviews out for the whole world to see. You can't stop me.
You win this round, Zane. But this isn't over.
Man, that felt good. I feel great now. I feel like I can review anything.
Come on, wrestling gods. Give me your best shot. I'll review anything.
Oh, shit.
I got the power. I got the speed. This body rules in the ring.